dear colleagues, for the past 10 years, environmental rights, including the rights provided by Aarhus Convention and mechanism of its protection, have not been in the government, Moldova government agenda's priority list. An analysis at the level of policy areas showed that largest discrepancy within the governance and human rights policy area. The vast majority of its specific objectives, about 92%, are not including in the National Development Strategy Moldova 2020. The course that the NDC Moldova 2020 revolved mainly around issues of economic development and focused less on other policy areas. On the central level, we can observe the continuing trend of neglecting environmental rights, and the Aarhus Convention implementation remains problematic. Since 2014, Moldova not submitted any report on the Aarhus Convention implementation. Also, the last action plan for the implementation of the Aarhus Convention covered the period 2011 to 2015. Since then, no policy document outlining a clear schedule or and concrete steps to implement the Aarhus Convention. The draft action plan for the implementation of the Aarhus Convention for 2020-2022 remains a mere intent on paper and has never been open for public consultation. The new government priority action plan for the next few years, which was recently discussed during the public consultation organized by the new created Ministry of Environment, does not include any action plan for the implementation of the Aarhus Convention proposed to be included by the non-governmental organization association Eco-TIRAS. This case shows that there is a limited understanding within the government and the lead agencies on the need of communication and awareness raising. Requests for information are frequently ignored, and when responded, they are incomplete and the information provided is limited. Some public databases exist, although minority of information is in an electronic format, but there is no interconnection between these databases. The government has been trying to systematically restrict public participation in environmental decision-making. Public consultation of normative facts are largely limited to their publishing on websites, without holding actual public hearings and considering comments of the public. Majority of the environmental impact assessment procedure are not preceded by announcement regarding to the organization of public debates. We, in the report, describe some cases. Government corruption is still perceived as a main problem in Moldova. According to the World Justice Project's 2019 Rule of Law Index, Moldova obtained poor scores, among others, in current application of laws 107th place and civil justice 87th place. The justice sector reform process deviates from the requirements regarding transparency and integrity. Access to justice is hampered mainly by high cost of conducting technical inventories and protracted examination of matters by courts and authorities. General distrust in the judicial system leads to people avoiding access to justice, in particular any matter, including environmental, that might fall under judicial or administrative review. Without further delay, the Moldovan government should promote the adoption by the Parliament of relevant environmental laws to fully implement European Union environmental acquis, ensuring from the association agreement. Also, the Moldovan government should approve the National Development Strategy Moldova 2030 based on human rights, and the main reference document for sectoral strategies recently in August after the elections. This project drafts approved by the government was annulled by the parliament, and there is currently no other policy document on the development. The strategy Moldova 2030 should be adopted and lay down roadmap for sustainable development, preventing pollution and degradation of environment and involving the public in endeavors to achieve these goals. The action plan on the implementation of the Aarhus Convention, at least until 2025, should be elaborated based on clear methodology analyzing the factors which did not allow the realization of the previous period plan from 2015. The institutional reforms should also focus on reducing the expenses for operating public institutions, increasing capacity building and accountability within public institutions, and improving the quality and accessibility of public services. As regard to access to information, Moldova should transpose European directive on open data and the rules of public sector information, and amend the legislation on access information and formulate and delimitate clear provisions regarding categories of information of public interest and the costs. It's recommended to improve of regulation on public access to environmental information by including information registers for the public interest and clarifying definition on reasonable costs. As regard about public participation, Moldova should further improve the functioning of the mechanism for public participation in environmental impact assessment by establishing a detailed procedure, including a public consultation procedure for review by the public of the impact environmental assessment documentation on proposed activities. And of course, by ensuring that the public comments and opinions are taken into account in the decision-making process. As regards to access to justice, Moldova should elaborate the compensating mechanism and compensate the part of cost of litigation, and might encourage people to seek legal assistance and bring environmental matters before courts. And of course, it will be better if we amend the law on state-guaranteed legal aid in terms and conditions and principle regarding partial or fully compensation of qualified legal assistance in mediation, as well as conventional forms of examination of environmental cases. Next slide, and thank you very much for attention.